someone who wears black even when nobody's dead. Girls, I have a brilliant plan. What you want, owner, what you want is me. But you need to see me in a brand new domain. Yes, it's plain. Warner, in a different setting, you will see you're getting all of this plus a brain. I'll meet you there at Harvard with a book in my hand. Big sturdy book, big wordy book, full of words I'll understand. And right there is where you'll see it too. Warner, what you want is right in front of you. It's clear, right here. Is right in front of you, in front of you. What you want. Harvard Law, so I get in there to make Warner reassess, impress him with my high IQ. We throw a great big wedding and invite all felt to new.
That's great. Nice plan. Now can we think this through? Harvard Law School?
I have a 4.0 average.
Yeah, and fashion merchandising. What makes you think you can do this?
Well, I'm doing this for love, and love will see me through. Yes, with love on my side, I can can refuse a love so pure and true.
Don't lawyers feel love too? Even if they do.
What you want, sweetheart, is no easy thing. If you're going to swing it, it will wreck your senior spring. Yeah, it's true. First, you'll need an LSAT score of more than 174. So no more parties for you. You'll need a killer essay or do not even home. And glowing letters from your betters. Know the Pope.
Oh no,
too bad, cause that would be a coup. And you've got a lot of work in front of you.
Hey everybody, it's the Spring Fleet Fashion
Extreme!
Not for you, we can either party or get into Harvard Law. Time to study. No. Go! Not good enough. Try again. Go! Hold on! 151. Still not Harvard material. Once again. Go!
Who was kind enough to send in a headshot?
It says here she has a 4.0 average.
Yes, in fashion merchandising.
And she has a 175 on her LSAT. There's also a letter of recommendation from Oprah Winfrey.
I'm not arguing that Miss Wells is entirely unqualified.
I'm what you want, Harvard. I'm the girl for you. And to prove it's true, we all put here on the blue. Thank you. About love, you ever been in love? Cause if you have, you'll know that love never accepts a defeat. No challenge it can't meet, no place it cannot go. Don't say no to a woman in love,
Harvard.
November, so it's been a while. So I'd like to invite Casey up here. Casey's in seventh grade at Sussman. She also played Elle. Brisace played one cast of Elle Woods, and Casey was in the other cast. So she's gonna sing another Elle Woods song from Legally Blonde. Here at the expo, and this year she's playing one of our Matildas. And Zoe, can you step forward? Zoe, who sang Kate in the Legally Blonde moment, she's also playing our other Matilda, so you can both wave. Woo! British accents and all, people. So thank you, Zoe. Ella's gonna sing a song from Matilda. Remember, come out in 3 weeks, and she's gonna sing Naughty.
Went up the hill to fetch a pail of water, and so they say the subsequent fall was inevitable. They never stood a chance, they were written that way. I wonder why they didn't just change their story. We're told we have to do what we're told, but surely sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty. Because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, nothing will change. Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. And if it's not right, you have to put it right. But nobody else is gonna put it right for me. Nobody but me is gonna change my story. Sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty.
Thank you, Ella.
Wow. As a musical kid, as a musical theater kid myself, this just shows you when you have support from DFEO, Downey Unified, the gift that these kids have, and we can help them develop it. I'm sitting there and I'm just super overwhelmed because it's also all the parents that are here today. As a teacher myself, I want to say thank you for being here because we know what a commitment it is for the parents as well. So let's give the parents a round of applause. All the lessons you have to drive them to, and then you have to pick them up and take them to baseball or, I know. So I wanna say thank you to the parents. So I wanna invite Ricky up. This is Ricky. You guys wanna go places? Places? Ricky's in sixth grade at Stauffer. And this is her first year doing musical theater, and I'm so proud of her. And we're gonna do a song from Matilda called Bruce, and Ricky will be singing the opening part. So when you're done. Well, I said the part opens. Revolting Children from Matilda. Standing up straight. I'm so proud of you, this one.